means mean absolute deviations, and second is bias. Bias means whether we have forecasted, that is underestimate or overestimate. And mean absolute deviations, normally for one MAD, this is equal to 0.8 deviations. This is the statistical part. One MAD is equal to 0.8 deviation is there. This is the normal things we require. Now you have to put this data in these two formula and calculate the MAD and absolute deviations. Then what is the difference? Okay. So let us we take this first MAD. This is equal to summation of n t raised to 1, this is the period, and difference in demand and forecasting, this is the positive difference, divided by n. So what is n actually? This is the actually period, 1 month 2 month 3 month. So here's n, this is equal to 3. Now, in order to calculate this, only difference you have to take. So first difference, demand and forecast. So what is the demand here? For March, 5000 minus 4600 plus April. What is demand? 6000 minus 6500 plus for May 7000 minus 7300 and divided by 3, because period is 3. Because the period is 3,
divided by 3.
So
हेलो, नाउ इट इज विजिबल। हेलो,
यस
आर यू गेटिंग माय साउंड? हेलो हेलो, ओके। Now, mad errors that we have calculated as per the given formula, demand minus forecast divided by n. So just we have taken the difference between demand and forecast of March, April and May divided by number of observations. Answer we have got, that is the 400. Actually, what is this thing, whether you are getting this thing? Demand and forecast. Forecast already you know the estimations. It is not accurate, correct? But demand is actually requirements. Demand is actually requirement. Now in the total actual requirement and the forecasting, if you calculate the mean absolute deviations, then it is actually 400 means 400 mean absolute deviation is there. Okay, so this is the one statistical part, but the questions in your exams will be like this. Calculate MAD, you can use this formula. Only difference you have to get, only difference you have to get. Okay, now we'll calculate this bias. This bias, so while calculating this bias, what should be there? 5000 minus 4600 is 5000 minus 4600 plus 600 minus 5,500 plus 7,000 minus 7,000. Here we have to take sign. Here we have not taken any signature or what we call the symbol. We have not only just we have taken the difference, but yes, we have to take the direction. This comes under the direction, this comes under the direction. So 5000 minus this, so how much here? 4400, but yes, it is a minus. It is minus, and here is also minus. So this is actually difference between this. Here direction we have taken and here we have taken magnitude. Difference we have taken. Here we have taken the direction. So here 500 plus 308. So this is actually divided by 3. This is actually negative. Now see, here's while calculating the bias, what I have done, whatever difference either plus or minus that I have taken as it is, correct? You see the left side bias, I have taken difference as it is along with this sign, maybe positive or negative, but in the right side only I have taken difference. Okay, so the MAD we have got answer of 400, but bias we have got the answer minus 133. So what that negative sign indicate? So in this bias, negative sign indicate underestimations,
Now this side, it is actually under estimation. Under estimation, whatever calculations related to demand and forecast, under estimation. But once the answer is plus, that is over estimation. Over estimation. So these are the difference between here. Right. So remaining same things are there. Just we can put this value and calculate. These things are there. But only the main difference between MAD and bias is like this. Here we have taken only magnitude, not direction. Because we have taken divided by number. But here the difference along with the indication may be minus or plus. Whatever answer here, what is the minus? Okay. So minus signifies by underestimation. Plus is that this is the overestimation. Okay. So these are the common types of errors in the forecasting. Correct. So have you got this concept? Forecasting errors. Hello. Two errors we have calculated. Remaining two you have to calculate, put with you for your informations. But in your GATE exam, sometimes the questions related to types of forecasting errors, formula will be there, and after that they will ask these formulas related to MAD, related to mean sum square errors or bias or tracking sigma. Correct. Sigma. So here's two numerical problem related to two errors we have solved. I think you might have got this concept. Okay. If anybody having any problems, you can ask. Otherwise, the last part of forecasting, that I will continue. Okay. So newcomers, you having any doubt, you can ask me. Hello, or shall I proceed? Hello. Shall I proceed? Next part of forecasting, that is the last part. Hello. Are you getting my sound? Okay. So shall we go for next part of forecasting? Okay. So we'll go for next part of forecasting. So this is the last part of our forecasting regressions analysis. Our next name is given there, least square method.
ऑफ एनालिसिस। व्हाट इज दैट रेग्रेशन? रेग्रेशन एनालिसिस इज द मैथमेटिकल मेथड्स method of obtaining best fit of relation between dependent variables and independent variables. The linear relationship between x and y it is given. Okay, for example, always we have two parts, that is sales and demand. Sales means forecast and demand is actually requirement is there. So here's two parts are there. There is the forecast of sale. Forecast of sale. And here is the demand. Demand. Actually, sales may be 300 and forecast is that is 200. So remaining 100, that is the error. So relations between demand and forecasting, we have to keep. What is that relation? That should be the linear relation. So that should be linear relation. So this is actually dependent variable and this is the independent variable. The dependent variable and this is independent variable. Demand means actual requirement is there, not depend upon others. But forecasting, it depends upon so many factors. Okay, so this is actually dependent variable and this is the independent. Okay, so here's the dependent variable. Here I will write dependent variable. And here is the independent. So in our forecasting, two types of variables are there. One that is the sales or forecasting, and second is the demand. Actually demand, it is not depend upon any other factor, but sale forecast, this is depends upon many factors. Okay, so let us we consider this dependent variable, this is the y, and independent variable, this is the x. So we have to find out the linear relationship between y and x. Linear relationship between y and x. So this relationship, it is actually indicated by y a plus b x. It is already proved that in regression analysis, this is the statistic part. It has been proved that the linear relationship between dependent variables means forecast or sales, and independent variables, that means demands, or that is called x. So this relationship, it is indicated by the line. So this line equations already I have written on the blackboard. That is the y is equal to a plus b x. Now, how to calculate A? Now, this we have to calculate A of B. So, A we have to calculate summation of y divided by y. And B, summation of x, y divided by summation. Means this A and B we have to calculate by given data. By given data, we have to calculate. By given data, we have to calculate A and B. Correct. So and P. Now, where the N is the number of observations, N is the number of observation, and A and B, that is the relation kept between A, X and Y. A we can calculate by using dependent variables Y. B I calculated by using both variables as shown on the blackboard. Okay, so let us we take one example. So like this example, it is given month January to July, and sales it is given for month January. Sales is given 44,329, February 44,670, March 48,670, April 45,784, May 47,676, January 55,730, and July 74,968. So deviation period for X. So here 7 readings are there. So deviations, while calculating the deviations, we can select the middle part. So here 1, 2, 3. So this part, and from this you have to take the deviation. So here this minus this, we have 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Just we can make use of this and get it deduct from this, you get the answer. Similarly for this. This is the deviation here. This is called x. Now square of the x, here is the 9, 4, 1, 0, 1, 2. Okay. Clear? Up to here it is clear? Okay. Deviation of period x, it is given x square
we can calculate after that x and y. Means this is y, this is x. So here it is minus 1, 3, 2, 9, 7, 8. Means this and this multiplication. Take one. Minus 8, 9, 2, 2, for this. Minus 4, 8, 6, 7, 8, 4, 7, 6, 7, 6, 5, 7, 4. Just the multiplication of 8 and 1. After that, you can make an decision to say one, summation of y. Okay, so what is the summation of y? So here it is 3, 4, 1, 8, 7. You can take the summation of y. 3, 4, 1, 8, 2, 7. Okay. Now summation of the x is 0. Summation of the x square. So summation of the x square, this is the 28. And summation of the x square is the 0. So that's the matrix summation. Right. So this is the summation of all these. Okay. Now you can put this value. All these values you can put in this equation. So here 5. You have to calculate y. First of all, you have to calculate a. Summation of y divided by. What is summation of y here? This. Summation of 1 is 1. Summation of 1, 3, 4, 1, 8, 2, 7. This value is divided by. This is the divided by 7. So my answer is 48. First we have to put this value. This value is 8. Then C. See what is summation of x bar? Summation of x bar is 53,043. So here summation of x bar divided by n. So we have 53,043.
Clear? Hello? Up to here it is clear? Just we have to find out A and B. How to find out A and B? From the given data, sales, deviation, and XY value, that you have to make the summation of this. And from that, you have to calculate A and B. Okay. So anybody having any doubt, you can ask, or shall I proceed? Hello? Related to this problem, if anybody having any doubt, or shall I repeat this? Hello? Shall I repeat this? Or shall I proceed? Hello, are you getting my sound? Okay, no problem. So we'll proceed.
So this A and B value you have to put in this equation. So here,
pi is equal to what is AM 48 plus what is PM? So this is the actual relationship between our sales and demand. The equation analysis. Now, sometimes question is that what should be the forecast for fourth deviation? If here they have given July up to July for August, if we want to calculate the forecast for August. Forecast for month of August. Forecast for month of August. What should be the deviation? 1, 2, 3. In month of August deviation will be 4. So here instead of x, we can write 4. So here the y is equal to 4 8 1 8 9 4 1. My answer is that this is the 56. The same forecast for month of August. Same forecast for month of August. Okay. Now, what is the trade value of Y? Trade value of Y.
In this situation, what is the trade value of Y? Trade value of Y. What is the trade value of Y? What is actually the sales of trade? Trading sales. Normally we are calling trading sales. So what is that sale? So if we start in January, February, March, April, like this deviation we have to suppose to X. Means one example, suppose Y value for this for month of January, 4, 8, 8, 3, 2, 1, 8, 9, 4, 8, -3. This is month for January. And February 5 will be 4, 8, 8, 3, 2, 1, 8, 9, 4, -3. 4 months. After that, March 4, 8. 8, 9, -1. Then after this, 18.
to be asked in your exam related to this. Very simple things are there. What is actually regression? So just I will explain in brief. What is the regression? Regression analysis means analysis of sale forecast and demand with particular period. Always sales, this is the dependent variable you have to suppose as a Y, and X is actually independent variables you have to suppose to be X. Now the relation between forecast and demand in statistical things, it has been proved that there is a one line. So this line equations is equal to Y line equations. This is equal to Y A plus B X, where the A and B, these are the coefficient of this regression analysis. And these two we have to calculate as shown on the blackboards. A, that is equal to summation of Y divided by N. Y is the sale forecast, N is the numbers, period, month period, year period, like this. B, we can calculate summation of XY divided by summation of X square. Now, some numerical problems will be there. Month and sales, if it is given, then you have to prove the relationship between Y and X, like this question will be there. Now, here I have taken 7 reading, but in gate exam, maybe 5 reading, 3 reading, like this questions will be there. So accordingly, we can go through this. But up till now, more weightage that is given on the words, which method is there? Smoothing, exponential smoothing method is there. That is the most probable 90% questions will be there. But here regression analysis, very less questions up till now it has been asked. So first, by using this chart, first we have to calculate deviation period, means middle value you have to take, and that middle value you have to deduct from each value of given tables. For example, in the present methods, middle value is April. That you have to deduct from January, February, March. Corresponding deviation is -3, -2, -1. And in front of April, 0. Similarly, you can calculate May, June and July. This is 1, 2, 3. Now, square of deviation, it is given in the next column, that is X square. After that, X and Y multiplication is there. After that, you can take the summation of all. And after taking the summation of all, you can put the particular value of A and B. That how to calculate A and B, it is given on blackboards. First of all, by using these tables, you have to calculate A and B value, and then you have to put into this equation relationship between demand and forecast. It is given by the equation. Now, suppose by using this, sometimes the question will be there, forecast the unit for month of August by using above relation. So here's a deviation for next month, means in month of August, deviation always be 4, means after 3 always be 4. So you can put there X, that is equal to 4. The Y should be 5608, means in month of August, the sales or forecast will be 5608. Okay, now what is the trade? Demand and forecasting, what is the trade, whether it is decreasing or increasing, that we have to decide by putting
x value, that is the deviation minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 in the given equation. Which equation? Y that is equal to 48 and 832 plus 1894 x. In place of x, you have to put minus 3, calculate, minus 2, calculate, minus 1, calculate, 0, you can calculate, 1, 2, 3 like this, and decide the trade. Trade will always be growing up. Correct. So this is about the regression analysis in the forecasting. Okay. So I think nearly about the all parts we have covered related to your GATE exam. Once again, I will repeat, and Monday onwards, we will go for revision of our total this subject. So why I have taken this much related to your GATE exam? Because this year's you have got the permissions for appearing the GATE exam. Okay, so that's why related to my subject, what is the importance from the GATE point of view that I have taken? Okay, just you can go through the what things actually I have given to you. If anybody having any questions, you can ask, or you can go to the book also. So I will give the points what actually I covered. So this is the completed part of syllabus, and Monday onwards we will go for revision of our subject. So first we have gone through the industrial engineering work study, method study, productivity, production, standard times calculation, different types of the flow charts. Okay, so normally in this industrial engineering, symbolic things will going to ask which type of chart, when we can use like this, and standard time calculation part is there. Next thing which is the importance from the GATE point of view is the linear programming, simplex methods that we have studied, other method which is not in our syllabus, and it is actually not the questions in your GATE exams related to remaining method. Okay, after this assignment and transportation, we have solved the number of questions, which is a very important from the GATE point of view. After that, critical path methods, and that is PERT and CPM, CPM and PERT, that two things we have covered. After that, sequencing, line balancing, break-even analysis, inventory control, and forecasting. This much parts we have covered in our all this lecture. Okay. So I think today's lectures, it is more than sufficient from the GATE point of view. You can just take a hint of what the problems I have given to you. Solve number of problems from the question papers, previous year's question papers, with proper understanding, we have to solve the questions, and then we can go for a GATE exam. Same part, forecasting, inventory control, break-even analysis, sequencing, balancing. The same part will get repeat in B, because there is a production and operation management subject is there. Similar parts will get repeat next years when you will be in the B. Okay. So I think today we have covered which is the importance from the GATE point of view. So anybody having any questions, you can ask me. Our time is only 3 minutes is left. Anybody having any questions? And once again, I will repeat, your exams, third year's exams will going to start in month of December. You have to go through the continuous our syllabus. Maybe offline or online exams will be there. already we have got the circular from the university. It is sent to your mails. You can, if it is not with you, you can ask to your CC. But online or offline exams must be there. Okay. So Monday onwards, our subject related revisions will be there. Those were absent, once again I will request to those students, those were absent for last few lectures, I will give chance to them to attend the lecture. Concept will get clear, attendance will get increased, it is beneficial to you, correct? So I think there is no questions from your side. Shall we stop here? Shall we conclude? Okay. So shall we stop here? Okay, thank you. We'll stop here because our time is over. And the last part we have covered, Monday onwards, revisions will be there.